With the water temperature just a couple of degrees warmer, the men will not be wearing wetsuits as the women did earlier in the day. 71 men, lots of pressure on a number of countries trying to oscillate back and forth whether or not they're going to be in the top eight to get those extra spots for the Olympic Games. The Russians right now battling it out with the Kiwis and the Canadians and Portuguese. And you can take a look, it's not too much of a surprise when it is a Russian leading. Both Ivan Vasilyev and Dmitry Polyansky, both very close to the front, but Burkhankov into that lead group as well. Three or four of the Russians in that lead group. Harry Wittschier, Petzold from Germany into that group as well. And off the water, it is Polyansky very quickly on. You can see about 45 or 50 men out of the water within less than a 15-second gap. But very quickly, it was James Elvery who needed a top eight in this race in Sydney to have a chance to qualify for the Olympic Games automatically. Ivan Vasilyev trying to show that he is one of the men the Russians should be considering. And as the 65 or 70 men, and a crash very early on the bike course, you can see so many men coming through right there. It looks like Hoffer, I think, one of the athletes going down in that crash. Eight laps, you can see the two men making a 35, 40, and then up to a 60-second gap. Ivan Vasilyev doing the majority of the work. Chris McCormack had ridden himself into that lead pack, just taking a bit of fluid, a couple of small breakaways for Chris McCormack, but it would be the two men up front, Ivan Vasilyev and James Elvery, with less than a minute gap between them and the chase group, with those two men who worked so hard out on that bike have a chance. Dmitry Polyansky along with Kyle Jones, Simon Whitfield, just a few of the athletes. But the big surprise of the day, Richard Murray from South Africa, a man who is a former world junior champion, had come through on a terrific bike and then got himself into a position to get his first ever podium in a World Triathlon Series race. Stefan Justus, who's been a podium athlete on a number of occasions, would have the race of his life after a top six in Mooloolaba. The elation on his face was absolutely appreciated. Stefan Justus, who had to look at Daniel Unger and Jan Frodeno, now is the man and the German program looking up at the top, his first ever victory in Sydney. Richard Murray coming in across the line in second, and Vidal from France, a very solid third, his third podium in less than a month.
Three weeks ago, it was solid with the sixth place in Mooloolaba, but I feel you can run faster and for sure you have a legs for the top five. Maybe when everything is working without the Brownies and Javier and Jan, it's a bit easier, of course, but it's still hard. And I know if everything is working, I can maybe beat everybody in a run. And